We're several
to get here and then lost Sacred Heart.
We're several minutes away from the opening tip-off here. It's a Friday night, December the 9th, I believe it is. Both teams are still trying to find their identity. Obviously, it's early in the season.
This is the 42nd game between these two schools. Minneapolis holds a 25-16 advantage. We played them last year in the first round of this tournament, beat them 72-47. We have a two-game winning streak on them right now. It'll be interesting to see if what we learned from the other night as a team, see if they can come together a little better and wipe out some of their mistakes and improve before we head into NCAA play next week at Beloit. Fortunately, they won't have Mr. Crawford, but they'll have enough else. So we'll look forward to an interesting game here tonight, and we'll be back with it shortly.
Okay, folks, once again, we're ready for the opening introductions between the Minneapolis Lions and the Bennington Bulldogs. An in-county ball game.
Kind of a new-look Lions Club this year, Trace, with lots of new people on the floor starting for us.
That's
not a lot of veterans.
Yep. Bennington is coached by a Minneapolis fella, Tim Dolliff.
And the assistant coach is Tanzer.
Tanzer, yep.
First, for the visiting team, the Bennington Bulldogs, 5'10" senior. Number 12, Trey Lynn.
Trey Lynn, number 12 for Bennington. He's a 6-foot senior.
Number 10, Ryan Weedle.
Ryan Weedle, number 10, comes out for the Lions. Taylor Copas, 6-foot guard for the Bennington Bulldogs, comes out. Spencer Brown comes out for the Lions, number
23.
Kirby Smith comes out for the Bennington Bulldogs. He's 5'10" senior.
Well, that coach has got to be his brother-in-law then.
Yeah.
That's a family affair here.
I love that.
Trevor Atkins, number 24 for the Lions. Nick Brown, number 30 for the Lions, comes out. Trevor Knox comes out for the Lions. That's the starting lineup for Coach Williams' team.
Cameron had a knee brace on, I think, the first game. I don't see he's got it on tonight, so maybe he's starting to back in the swing of things with that one knee of his. I hope.
We hope. This is Trace Creel. I'll do the play-by-play along with Mike Perry. Lions take the floor.
Now, you got to give the years that we graduate.
Yes,
Trace,
sir.
Now,
I'm a graduate.
We're right in a row. That's why I wanted to be here tonight.
I'm 1971. Mike Perry's 1972. Dale Leach is 1970. Chuck Lomberger was 1980. He's just a pup.
He's a pup. A leopard. Just a beginner.
We're going to have Monroe jumping against Knox. Once again, this is an in-county game between Bennington and Minneapolis. Here's the opening tip-off. Controlled by the Lions. Over to Weedle.
Man to man, Trace.
Knox. Knox into Atkins. He puts it up. 2. Yes. Nice assist by Knox. Lions take out to a 2-0 lead. Full court pressure by the Lions. Nick Brown's on his man. Ball stolen by Atkins. Weedle with it. Weedle. Yes. Lions jump out to a 4-0 lead. Full court pressure put on by the Lions. Bennington breaks the press. Oh, he might have drugged his foot. He puts her up. Off, no good. Rebound by Brown. Nick Brown, a senior, brings it up. He's out front, stops, gives it off to Knox. Over to Brown. Over to Weedle. Weedle from downtown. Yes!
3 points for the Lions. Number 10,
Lions. Lions jump out to a quick 7-0 lead. Bennington breaks a press. Uh-oh, there's an easy bucket. No, he missed her. Too bad. Weedle. Yes!
Three in a row for Ryan, so we're starting off, everyone's starting off shooting hot here.
You betcha. Lions 9, Bennington nothing. They're going to get Atkins for a foul there, I believe. I don't think we've missed a shot yet, have we, Mike? 4 for 4.
Ken Lomberger in for Minneapolis. He's got a real nice stroke from three-point land. Well, I'm sure you'll see it here later on. He's got a nice shot.
Bennington with the ball. He inbounded. Stops. Back out front. Minneapolis in a man-to-man. Lomberger's on his man. Weedle's on his man. From 10 feet. Short, no good. Rebound, Bennington. Up from 8, in.
Basket for the Bulldogs. Number 21, Chris Mann.
Bucket by Mann. Under the bucket. Oh, they're going to say Atkins stepped on the line. That's going to be Bennington's ball. They trail 9-2. 5 minutes, 55 seconds left, opening quarter. Full court pressure put on by Weedle. Ball was kicked.
Jamel Townsend in for Minneapolis, logged lots of minutes. Pretty decent freshman.
Yep.
Also into the game for the Lions.
Along with Corey Lomberger, who's played quite a bit too, so.
Okay.
He's playing them all.
A couple substitutions there that might keep you informed of. 5 minutes, 44 seconds left. Bennington will inbound the ball. They're having trouble. They get her in. Man from downtown, no good. Weedle with the rebound. No, Lomberger, excuse me. Down to Lomberger. Pair of Lomberger brothers. Knox. Out to Weedle. Ryan with the ball. In the Knox. Lobs it into Townsend. Knocked out of bounds by Bennington. Taylor Copas knocked it out. Stopped the clock with 5:18 left. 9-2. Lions lead. Townsend's a freshman. Lomberger inbounds the ball to Weedle. To Lomberger from downtown. Off, no good. Bennington pushes the ball up. Look at that, Weedle with the steal.
Nice defense by the Lombergers to create that turnover over there, and Ryan was in the right spot, tipped by Kenton coming out of there and created a nice turnover. Easy bucket.
Easy bucket. 11-2.
Palming the ball.
Palming the ball.
He's using that left hand.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Substitution for the
Lions out to a nice 11-2 lead. 4 minutes, 51 seconds left, opening quarter.
Spencer Brown back in for Minneapolis and Trevor Atkins back in. Cameron knocks out. Jamel stays in and Corey stays in.
Spencer Brown inbounded. He's the sophomore over to Weedle, senior.
It's like they've gone to a little zone defense here, Trace.
Yep. Weedle. Off. No good. Oh.
Corey over the back trying to tip that ball out on that rebound. It's his first foul.
His first personal foul, second team foul. Into the game for the Lions, number 3, Kendall Pumper, and number 42, Cameron Knox.
Cameron comes in for Jamel, and Kenton comes in for Ryan. Ryan will get a breather.
Bennington inbounds the ball. They're having troubles.
Well, that's about
Smith
seven.
With the ball.
Stay with him, Corey.
Uh-oh.
Reach-in foul on Corey. I know it was getting close to a 10 count. He was trying to put a little extra pressure on him right there. And it's two on him, so he'll probably have to grab a little pine here.
Bennington with the ball down in the corner. Back out front. Down the corner again. From 18 feet. Hard as a brick, no good. Rebounds by Bennington. Matt Monroe. From 10 feet, no good. Monroe with the rebound. He loses it. Minneapolis' ball.
We got to get on that defensive board, Trace.
Yes.
Will Corman in is going to give Corey a break.
Substitution for the Lions in game number 10, Ryan Weedle.
Talk about a little jitterbug. He can go either hand between the legs, behind the back, and, he's handled the ball.
He can handle the ball. Will Corman, number 0 for Minneapolis, sophomore. Going to have Lomberger inbound to Weedle. Over to Corman. Out to Weedle. Lomberger. Corman. Weedle. Weedle drives back to Corman. From 12. No good. Ball being fought for.
Off Cameron there. Bennington will play it in.
Bennington has the ball.
You didn't agree with that call, Trace?
No, not really. Drew Rathburn threw it in to Kirby Smith. Bennington with the ball. Minneapolis in a man-to-man. 11-2, Lions lead. 3 minutes, 26 seconds left, opening quarter. Bennington looking for their shot. Oh! Stolen by Knox, picked up by Corman. The little...
Bennington tried to save it right in, threw it off Ryan, and Ryan just caught it.
Yeah, it was... There's Knox. No, baby, no. Weedle, yes.
Good offensive board there by Ryan. Cameron had to use the left hand to block himself to keep the Bennington guy from blocking his shot, and it just rimmed out.
Weedle was where he usually is, where the ball is. There's Bennington. Oh, they're going to call a foul on Knox on that.
But he wasn't going to get the shot off.
He didn't get the shot off, that's right. He's going to have to earn it. We're here at the Bicentennial Center in Salina, Kansas. First shot up by Bennington is in. Trey Lynn, he's 5'10 senior from Bennington.
Well, he's kind of consistent playing everyone like he did the other night, Dale.
Yes, it is. And I like that. I just need that all season. Bring in 4 or 5 bodies all the time.
Second shot's good. 13-4, Lions lead. Lion push the ball up. Out front to Atkins. Tweedle from downtown. Yes, baby.
3 foot beyond the arc. Ryan hammers down another 3, and that's his second of the night. 16-14, Minneapolis. There's a trap, half-court trap.
Bennington breaks it from 8. Short. Get the ball, boys. Oh, they're going to give it to Minneapolis. Hey.
I think we might have evened it up there.
I think so, Mike.
Jamel with a quick hand in there. It went out of bounds off Bennington, and Minneapolis will have possession here with 2:12 left in the first quarter.
It's been all Lions so far. Weedle with the ball off the Lomberger. That's Kenton. Junior off to Townsend, over to Brown. Brown from downtown. Wow!
Oh, yeah. 3-pointers are going in tonight.
Yes, sir, Mike Perry. 19-4.
They're going to call blocking foul on Ryan.
I disagree with that. I thought the guy pushed off on him, didn't you?
Ryan just a little bit late getting there.
No. I thought he pushed off, but Bennington with the ball. Minute 40 left, first quarter. They're looking from 8 feet. Off, no good. Weedle with the rebound. Oh.
Hey, he grabbed him from behind. That's why he lost the ball.
Yeah.
And it's their first foul.
Yeah. Drew Rathburn, his dad was a heck of a player back in our day for Lincoln. Brown, back out to Atkins. Over Weedle, baseline.
Now, that was a blocking foul when you slide over like that. And
yeah.
They didn't call it there, so.
I mean.
Trace, you got to watch what you say about Lincoln.
Oh, yes. We got a Lincolnite here. Hey, that stops the clock with a minute 22, Mike Perry. 19-4, all Lions.
Good start by the Lions. It's cold outside, but we're warm in air.
Yes, sir.
19-point first quarter with a minute 22 still left in it. A little better start tonight, Dale.
Definitely better. And it's a little bit of difference on how much defensive pressure is being put on Drew Weedle, Ryan Weedle, tonight compared to the other two games.
Do you remember old Rathburn over there from Lincoln? Galen?
Dalen,
yes. He was a good ball player.
And that's something he's going to have to fight all year long, so he might as well learn how to fight through it and get him up anyway.
Both teams are back on the court. Bennington has the ball. They trail 19-4. Bennington inbounds it. Atkins with the steal.
Tip by
he takes
Ryan.
It all the way in. No good. Ball's being fought for.
Trevor kind of got undercut there and missed the layup and looked like a tie-up. Possession arrow to Bennington.
Yep. Bulldogs with the ball. 1 minute, 8 seconds left. Opening quarter. Bennington across the center court. From 18 feet. It drew nothing. What's it going to be, ref?
Jamel tipped it off of Bennington. Should be Minneapolis ball. Jamel 54 seconds left. Should we play for one?
No, let's just keep putting it to him. Weedle with the ball. Oh, into Townsend. Nice move.
He's left-handed.
Yes! Bucket's good. He'll go to the line. How about that, Mike?
Block that shot. He's left-handed, and it was blocked. He couldn't block that anyway. Jamal can really jump.
Yeah. Just a freshman.
Just an easy layup.
Yeah.
He brought down a rebound the other night. Tracy went up with one hand and just brought her down.
Good deal. Missed the free throw. Bennington gets the ball. 21-4.
Minneapolis still that man-to-man, Trace.
Bennington back out front. We got something.
I think they caught Jamel with a hold there in the paint. I think he was beat going down the lane. They didn't see him. They weren't going to pass it to him, but it's his first foul.
Yeah. He'll go out on that. 27 seconds left. So far, I like what I see.
Yeah, they're a scrappy bunch. Trayer Gassman in now for Minneapolis. Trays
for three. No good. Oh, hey, yeah. Nice move by Atkins.
Stripped away
Whoops.
By Trevor.
Bad move by Atkins. In and out. No good. What we got there? Oh, come on now.
I got Trevor with a push off. It was just blocking out, and they got him with a hold. Trevor's second foul.
21-4 with 8 seconds. That's going to send Joe Freeman.
Well, they're in the 1-1. That's what it is. I was wondering why they were shooting. It was on the floor, but it's seven fouls.
Yeah.
They're in the 1-1.
Bennington only has two fouls. But yet we have the lead, 21-4. First shot by Freeman.
I'm sure that would be Ed and Vera's.
Well, I suppose it is.
You knew Will was Jim's son.
Yeah,
Well, Tom's got a bunch of boys coming up. They're pretty young yet.
Yeah.
Peyton Owens in for Minneapolis.
We got 6 seconds, folks. Hey! They wanted a foul there, Mike Perry.
Well, we wanted one there, they wanted one there, so I guess it was kind of
we wanted two, and they wanted one, and there was none, so. Folks, that's the end of the first quarter, 21-6. It's been all Lions.
Good first quarter. He plays quite a few on this team. He'll go right down the line and play 10 or 12 deep on this.
Uh-huh.
All the boys seem to get in and get a play.
Yep.
So I think he's still kind of looking for combinations and the right people at the right time, but shooting the ball pretty good tonight.
Yep.
Got some stats for us, Dale?
I'm working on it.
Oh, thank you, Chris.
Oh, that's right. Dale's daughter was at the top of the pyramid. We couldn't get his attention.
We were 9-14 that quarter. For shooting. 0-for-3 throws. 0-for-1 for 3 throws.
Point total.
Both teams are back on the court to start the second quarter. Okay. Minneapolis will have the ball. Brown into Lomberger. He crosses center court. Stops. Into Weedle from 8. Short. Ryan with a good own rebound. He'll get that, baby. He won't miss that twice, I'll guarantee you, folks. 23-6, Lions. Bennington breaks the press. Oh, they're going to get Weedle with the foul there, but
he had his hands on the top and the bottom of the ball, and it came out. They called a foul on Ryan.
Yeah, I don't, you know. I'd throw a red flag on that if I could, but that's football. It's just the start of the second quarter, folks, here in the consolation game.
Starting to look like a little foul trouble. Ryan has two, Trevor has two.
Yep. 23-7.
And Corey.
Misses the second one. Weedle with the ball. Knox had the rebound. Over to Brown. He takes it in. He's fouled. Somewhere, somehow.
At least once.
At least once, yes.
He'll shoot two. Got to make those free throws, Trace. Kind of like the Jayhawks.
Yes, oh mercy. Spencer shoots a second. He hits that one. 7:33, second quarter, 24-7. Full court pressure by the Lions. Well, they made that too easy.
Yeah, entry pass inside, and Bennington with an easy bucket.
Lomberger over to Brown. Top of the key, dribbles back out. Over to Knox. Lumberger thought about it. He drives in from 8 feet. Yes!
Had a good look at a three and passed it up and drove to the paint for an easy 8 footer.
Yes, I like that. 26-9, 6:42 left. From downtown for Bennington. Knox, nice job there. Wheeler with the ball, he's gonna drive it. He stops from 15, yes.
Didn't have a clear path to pass that to Nick. Nick was open down the court and he just couldn't get him the ball.
Yeah. Bennington with the ball. They trail 28-9. Oh, a little razzle-dazzle there by number 13. Oh, Taylor Copas there. Minneapolis with the ball. Brown across the center court over Lumberger. Cross court to Brown. Weedle. Yes, sir!
30-11 with 5:54 left here in the first half. Yeah,
he's done it since he was a kid. Oh, I see there.
He was in deep trouble. He had to bounce it off his leg. All he could do.
We got a few substitutions there, Mike, I think.
Will Corman, Trevor Atkins, Peyton Owen, Jamel Townsend, and Corey Lomberger's back in.
Bennington with the ball. Copas.
I don't really think it matters if they got two fouls on him. Coach Williams still wants them to play hard.
Uh-huh, you betcha.
Look at there. Atkins with a dive out of bounds. Left a little skin there, I think.
Weedle's 9-for-11 so far. Ryan Weedle's 9-for-11 so far tonight.
Good.
Shot no good by Bennington, but they get the rebound. Inside to Monroe. He's pushing his way. Oh, come on now.
I think Jamel Townsend with his second.
My God, he was going through like a bowl in a China store, Mike.
He was a backing in there.
My golly.
Big boy.
Well, I mean, that may be true, but.
You know, they're making their free throws,
yeah.
Too.
30-12. 5 minutes, 23 seconds left, first half. Monroe shoots the second one. Lumberger has the ball. Over to Atkins. Over to Owens. Takes it all the way in. Yes!
Nice layup there.
Handed
by
Owens.
Owen.
Nice play. That's the way to break that full court press, Mike Perry.
Quick passes and right in the passing lanes. Peyton Owens, nice little layup.
Yep. Well, that Monroe's on fire. Owens with the ball. Gets it up to Townsend. Knocks out of bounds by Monroe.
Substitution for the Bulldogs. Number 24, Joe Green.
4 minutes, 45 seconds left. Till half.
For the Lions, number 42, Cameron Knox.
Cameron Kenton and Ryan back in for Minneapolis. Good minutes by Corey.
Atkins with the ball. Stolen. Oh, they missed an easy layup. Thank golly. Weedle with the ball. Over to Lumberger. Back out to Atkins. Weedle from downtown. Yes. He's an assassin, folks. Oh, yes. Ball up to Lumberger. Nice play there.
Nice. Body control
Kenton
by Kenton.
Lumberger. Very smooth. 37-15. That was a nice little run by the Lions, Mike.
They break the press. Oh, Trevor, almost.
Trevor's playing hard defense.
He had a save the other night going out of bounds over here with his left hand and flipped it like that, went way up in the air. Of course, that was our goal that went here. We just happened to get it, and then we got a basket.
Yeah.
It was a heck of a save.
Playing hardball.
Yeah.
3 minutes, 55 seconds left, first half. Bennington with the ball. Freeman has it. He's a senior.
He's a big boy.
That he is, my friend.
Kind of looks like Bennington's resting here just a little bit.
They're in no position to rest. They can do that on Sunday. Nice shot there by number Atkins down deep. Little turnaround, yes.
Oh, yeah. He's a lefty.
Oh, you got to love them lefties.
Canton with a good defense.
He traveled, I thought. Knox with a rebound. Hold up, Trevor.
One extra step, but not called.
Weedle with the ball. Knox, Dindakins, he'll shoot her left-handed. No.
Just a little bit too high off the glass.
2:47 left, Minneapolis 39-18.
Nice turnaround jumper in the paint by
Trevor. Yes, it was. Cameron with another rebound. Oh, he got a call for traveling.
Trevor not even looking for the ball. Outlet should have came over here to Ryan, and
yeah.
Cameron threw it right off
yeah.
Trevor's chest. He just wasn't looking for it. 39-18, 2 minutes and 33 seconds. Still left here in the first half.
Yep. We want to protect this lead. I mean, we don't want Bennington to go on any kind of roll here, and this last 2.5 minutes, you want to keep pouring it to them.
We had a little drought the other night against Halstead, a 13-0 run, and we had a 12-0 run against them, and it was kind of a
Weedle, yes,
finger roll. Three-pointer.
Wow!
That looked good all the way, didn't
it? Yes, it did, Mike. 41-21, 1:54 yet till half. Weedle brings it up. Over to Gaspin.
Bad pass. Turnover Minneapolis.
Bennington with the ball. From 8 feet. Short. Come on, guys, get them rebounds. Bennington still has the ball. Bennington sets it back up. From three. Boo!
They're gonna have to guard him.
Cuts the lead to 17. Brown. Cameron. Short. Freeman with the rebound. 50 seconds left.
Out of bounds. Foot was out of bounds.
Yes, it was, yes.
Substitution in the game. Number 32.
Trevor Atkins and Jamel Townsend back in for Minneapolis.
Trevor Atkins, and number 3, Kenton
Lawford. And Kenton's back in for Minneapolis.
We got Dale Leach keeping stats for us tonight.
It just cost us a small bucket of popcorn, but he said he'd do it.
Oh, he'll do it, sure. Okay, Weedle, the senior, brings it up across the center court. 34 seconds left. He's a veteran. Nothing rattles him.
23 seconds.
Uh-oh, he was fouled.
Oh. Minneapolis on the floor gives the ball to the Bulldogs.
Boy, he got hacked.
Oh, man.
Big time.
Bennington wants to take advantage of this. 17 seconds left. Norris with the ball. Oh, come on.
Out front, Ryan just gets mugged out there, and they call a little touch foul like that.
I mean. That's about ridiculous. Well, if it's poetic justice, he'll miss it, but he knows he shouldn't have to be up there.
Well, you're right.
Yeah, well, you know, he knows it. He'll shoot one more. 9 seconds left.
Yeah, we definitely need to block out here and let them have a second chance here.
Hey, he didn't even hit iron. Weedle.
Good grief. They won't call foul for nothing.
Folks, that's the end of the first half. 41-24, 17-point lead for our Minneapolis Lions. Mike Perry.
Oh, I should have covered up the mic when I yelled at the ref.
We'll be back with some stats. And
I think Dale might be close. No, we're going to have to come back. It was a pretty good first half, though.
Yeah,
Minneapolis come out shooting pretty hot, and Bennington pretty cold.
Yep. So anytime you got a 17-point lead at half, I like it.
We'll be back.
We'll be back.
All right, here's your halftime stats. Overall, the Lions hit 18 of 25 on their field goal shooting. So 72%, I think, roughly. And free throws, they were 1 of 3. Scoring for the Lions in the first half, Ken Lomberger with 4, Jamel Townsend with 2, Spencer Brown 4, Trevor Atkins 4, Peyton Owens with 2, and Ryan Weedle 25. He was 2, 4, 6, 8 of 10 on deuces and 3 of 4 on trays.
That's a mighty fine shoot.
With 4 rebounds for both he and Cameron Knox. And the foul trouble, we got Weedle, Townsend, Adkins, Corey Lomberger, each with 2.
Everybody's got 2.
We outscored them in the first quarter 21-6, and in the second quarter 20-18. So they got a lot more active in the second quarter, did the Bulldogs. I don't know if anybody's seen this publicized yet or not, but the substates are out. Minneapolis will be going to Osborne this year for substates. In our substate is El Saline, Downs Lakeside, Osborne, Plainville, Smith Center, Solomon, and Stockton. I would imagine, just guessing, our biggest competition out of that will probably be either Solomon or Smith Center out of those schools. Bennington is in 3A. They go to Beloit Substate.
Wouldn't want that draw.
No. Along with Norton, Oberlin, Phillipsburg, Riley County, Sacred Heart, and Salina St. John's.
Oh, mercy. That's a tough
Belleville will be in Washington's substate, along with Blue Rapids, Clifton, Clyde, Frankfort, Highland, Donovan West, Troy, Washington, and Wathena.
So that's at Beloit?
Yeah. Southeast will be in the Heston substate. And look at Ellsworth. They get to go all the way out to Lakin.
Unbelievable.
And the substate for wrestling will be for Minneapolis will be in Hoisington this year. Go ahead. Sorry.
I gotta show that off.
Yeah. Back with second half action shortly.
Okay, folks, we're back for the start of the second half. Trace Creed, Chuck Lomberger, Mike Perry, Dale Leach bringing you this game. From the Bicentennial Center in Salina, Kansas, consolation game between the Minneapolis Lions and the Bennington Bulldogs. Lions hold a 17-point lead. Minneapolis will inbound the ball. Brown to Atkins, to Weedle. Over to Brown. Into Knox. Knox turn around from 4 feet. No good. Knocks her out of bounds. All in 11 seconds. Nothing for the Lions, Mike Perry.
11 of 13 shooting from Ryan Weedle in the first half.
Hey, not bad.
Yeah. That's just the twos. He's 3 of 4 on the tray.
Man with the ball. Oh! Man with the bucket. Brown brings it up. No good. Oh, he gets his own rebound. Ball stolen. The Lions come out flat. 15-point lead.
The other night.
Bennington has the ball in the corner. Back out front. They trail by 15. Lynn has the ball. Stolen. Stolen back by Bennington. Nice play by Knox. Atkins with the rebound. Come on, guys, let's get going. Weedle with the ball. Ryan passes center court. Over to Brown. Back out front to Atkins. Over to Brown. Back to Brown from three. In and out, no good. Rebound, 4-on-1, but looky there. Ryan Weedle. Into Atkins, yes!
Nice pass, dish.
Nice play, Lions.
Atkins, they came to get Ryan and Trevor had a layup.
43-26, 6:19, third quarter from three. Woo! Taylor Copas hits her from way downtown. Cuts the lead to 14. Knox with the ball to Brown. Back to Knox.
Little gimmick defense here. They're in a zone except for one man that's playing Ryan.
Yep.
So it's a box and one is what I call it.
6:01 left, third quarter. Out to Lomberger. Brown from downtown, yes!
He hit that one. He'll have to hit him because they're going to cover Ryan up. He will not have 25 here in the second half.
Baseline move, nice move there by Copas. Oh, they got traveling there. Did you see that? I didn't. Okay, Dale said he did.
Looked like a good jump stop to me.
Yep. Full court pressure by the Lions. 5:29 left, third quarter. 46-31, 15-point lead. Bennington across the center court. They push off to do it, but they made it. Oh.
Boy, they jump into Kenton and they call Kenton with a foul. Bennington's going to shoot two.
Mercy, mercy. That's a lousy call. He was charging and using his elbow the whole way. Well, that he knew he didn't deserve it. That's why he missed it. He felt bad about it. He hits a second. Lions, Weedle with the ball across the center court. Lomberger, Atkins, lob into. Too much of a lob. Okay, timeout with 5:05. Mike Perry with 46-32, 14-point lead.
Coach Williams wanted that timeout. I was wondering who called the timeout, but Coach Williams wants a 30-second timeout. I think he's going to change his defense here just a little bit, or offense. He's recognized and wants to let the boys know that they're guarding Ryan all over the floor, man-to-man there, but the rest of them are, it's kind of a zone. It's, just as soon as I say that, Bennington will come out and switch. So.
Well.
As most good coaches do.
Yep. Lions back on the court. Bennington follows on the court. Third and fourth place game here. Early in the season. Bennington with the ball. Kirby Smith has it. Guarded by Brown. Oh, he lost it.
Nick almost picked his pocket there.
Well, that he did, but the Bennington retains possession. Copas will throw the ball inbounds. Monroe, the bull in the China store, had it. Nice move by the Bulldogs. Hey, they've got the lead to 12, Mike Perry. It's Lumberger. Lucky play there for Lyon from downtown. Yes!
Nick Brown, two of them over there now. Kept Lyons at a 15-point lead.
Nice three by Brown. Okay, bad pass by Bulldogs. That should be our ball. Yes. Turnover by the Bulldogs.
Substitution for the Bulldogs. Number 10 in the game.
Lions with a 15-point lead and the ball.
Lions in the game, number 42, Cameron Knox.
Lumberger inbounds at Atkins. Back to Lumberger. Knox from eight. No rebounders, Will.
Nobody there to rebound, and Cameron hadn't hit a shot yet tonight, so cold shooting by Cameron. Need to get him going. Nice steal by...
Well, how about a foul there? Trevor's playing good defense. Oh! Yes, sirree, double-double dribble.
Well, we thought we had a turnover. Bennington gets the ball back.
All right, Weedle with the ball. Ryan pushes it up hard to Brown. Brown stops, he's fouled. No foul is called.
Trevor beating on the baseline, uses the arm bar, and
I'll tell you one thing.
Blocking
that,
foul.
That number 20 that old Kirby Smith pushes off with his left left arm all the time. Constantly. They don't call it.
Trevor's third foul. Peyton Owens in for Minneapolis.
3:19 left, third quarter, folks. Lumberger called for the foul. That's Kitten. Lumberger.
Sure looked like he had all ball.
First shot's good.
That's Kenton's third foul, and Spencer Brown will come back in for Minneapolis. Bennington's hitting those free throws.
I'll tell you what. Brown with the ball. Clock's running, 3:15 left.
Another bad pass and a turnover in Minneapolis.
A little sloppy this quarter, Mike.
Yeah, lots of turnovers.
From downtown. Woo! Tell you what, they've cut her to a 10-point lead. They're back in the ball game. Brown. Bennington's got the momentum, folks. Bennington with the rebound. They shoot for three. No good.
Substitution for the Lions. 49-39. Bennington down to a 10-point deficit here. It's
2 minutes, 27 seconds left. Minneapolis has the ball.
I don't think Ryan's got a shot yet.
Been a sloppy third quarter, I think, for the Lions, it's safe to say. Weedle with the ball. Knox out front to Lumberger. To Brown from 8 feet. Yes.
Spencer with the bucket. Basket for the Lions, number 23. Traveling call on Bennington.
Well, how about?
Canton created a turnover down there. Yep. A little pressure. A little pressure. Substitution for the Bulldogs. Kent playing with three fouls. I heard Kent say, oh, don't foul.
Yeah. We don't need four. 2 minutes, 3 seconds left, third quarter. 51-39, Lions lead by 12. Well.
I had Spencer throwing the ball away two or three times tonight.
Three-point basket for the Bulldogs, number 10.
There they cut her down to single digits.
Still can. Scratch.
Minute 33 left, 9-point lead. It's been all Bennington this quarter.
Seven-point lead. I think that kid's trying to guard Ryan a little too close.
Substitution for the Bulldogs, number 20, Kirby Smith.
7-point lead. With a minute 10 left, we need to get some mojo going. Cameron.
Thank you.
Personal foul on the Bulldogs, number 24, Joe Freeman. His second personal.
51-44, Minneapolis. And
yes.
That one goes in. Now the drought's done with. Cameron scratches, and Minneapolis back to an 8-point lead.
Substitution for the Bulldogs, number 13, Taylor Copas.
We may have an interesting fourth quarter here. I didn't think at one time we would.
I didn't either. Cameron misses the second one. Free throw shooting. I think we've only made two tonight.
Bennington with the ball.
All Peyton Owens could do is grab him on the way by.
Yeah.
He'll shoot two.
Stops the clock with 51 seconds. Cuts the lead down to seven.
At the line for the Bulldogs, number 23, Wyatt.
Well, one time it was 39-18, I think. Sure is it now. 52-46, 6 points. It's been all Bennington.
Number
Brown. Back to Weedle. Knox. Lumberger from 10. No good.
Good job. Peyton Owens jumps in there to tie him up. Possession arrow goes to Bennington, but we get her next time.
Yes. Good hustle by Owens. 32 seconds left. Third quarter. Bennington crosses the center court. From downtown. No good. There should be a foul there. 13 seconds left. Brown. The Weedle. Yes. That's what we wanted.
Kenton Lomberger backside takes the pass and easy bucket for Kenton.
Yep. 54-46. 4 seconds left. We don't want Bennington to do anything with this ball now. And that's the end of the third quarter, folks. 54-46.
What a run by Bennington. They were down 21 at one time. Cut it back to an 8-point lead here. Start of the fourth quarter. Could be interesting.
Yeah.
We got outscored 22-13 that quarter, and they're going to have to find a way of getting Ryan Weedle the ball and a shot.
Yes.
Didn't even get a shot off that quarter. And we'll be back fourth quarter here shortly.
Start of fourth quarter, Lomberger to Weedle. Back to Lomberger. Out to Owens. Lubs in to Knox. He's fouled and the bucket's good. That's what we wanted, Mike.
Cameron Knox with the ball in deep. That's
yes.
Two.
Gives us a 10-point lead. Nice pass. He's going to send Cameron to the free throw line. He puts her up, and it is off. Bennington retains possession.
Spencer had a hand on it, but we couldn't control it.
They push it up hard. Stolen by Ryan Weedle. He'll push it up hard. Take it all the way in. Look at that, folks.
Layup. Coast to coast.
Coast to coast. Bennington across the center court. They trail by 12. 7:22 left. Minneapolis man-to-man. Bad pass by Bennington.
Minneapolis coming out a little bit further with that defense
now.
58-46. 7 minutes left in this contest.
Brown. Shots blocked.
Looks like Coach laid off a little bit intentionally in that third quarter on defense to stay out of foul trouble.
Possibly.
Bennington with the ball. 6:57 left in this contest. Rathman with the ball. Yeah!
He did it. And they called it,
Mike Perry. That's what's amazing. He's done it the whole game.
Nick in for Spencer and Trevor in for Peyton Owens. Peyton Owens was pretty good minutes there. Trevor with three fouls, so he had to kind of.
Both teams have four fouls. We're at 6 minutes, 45 seconds left in this ball game for consolation, third and fourth place. Lomberger with the ball. Over to Brown. Back to Lomberger. Over to Atkins. Come on, Trevor. He almost lost it, but
just
there it is back to Brown. Lomberger from downtown. Yes!
Oh, yeah, baby. Nice stroke by Kenton, top of the circle and beyond.
Nothing but net, baby.
That was back court.
It was.
He was in midair when he caught it. He came from back court, and the ball was already cross court, wasn't it?
Lions by 15. Hey, charging.
That was not that referee's call, and he's called it out on the floor. Blocking foul on Ryan Wheatle. It's his third.
He missed the first one. He missed the
and
second one.
And the second one.
Atkins with the rebound, pushes it off to Knox. Oh, he traveled.
It's the best call he's made all night. I'm supposed to cover up the mic when I say that.
We have a timeout on the floor.
Timeout. With 5:57 left. Minneapolis lead 61-56. I like that 15-point lead, Mike.
I always like a 15-point lead, especially when we're on top.
Bennington with the ball. Full court pressure by the Lions. Uh-oh. Traveling.
Trevor Atkins.
Nice defensive play by Trevor Atkins.
Yeah. Stuck a hand in there, and the Bennington player had to carry it.
Yep. Nice turnover there for us. Brown with the ball back out to Lomberger. Over to Atkins. Cross court to Brown. In the Knox turnaround from 4 feet, yes!
Nice one-hand turnaround jumper. Cameron Knox starting to warm up now. Trevor does dive out of bounds.
Yeah.
He'll go get it for you.
63-46, 5:31 left. It's been all Lions fourth quarter.
I believe it's a 9-0 run.
Bennington across the center court. From downtown. No. Lomberger. Stops, pops.
Oh,
yes.
Oh, nice move by
Kenton. He's slick, he's smooth. Kenton Lomberger, a junior.
Stepped back and took a 12-footer and nothing but net on 11-0 run. Tipped out by Minneapolis.
Get on him, boys. Turnover by the Lions. Looky there.
And they call a foul.
Yeah.
Cameron picks up the loose ball, goes in for
That's got the LA. Ladies from Bennington restless.
Did they call a foul?
Yes.
They did.
Yep.
Yeah.
He'll shoot too.
Good. Nice shot by Cameron.
Cameron's starting to find the range here in the second half. I think he's got 7 or 8 points.
Yeah. '66-48, 18-point lead. At one time, I think it was 6, Mike. Yes.
In and out and around and up and down.
Then.
And in. 67-48, Minneapolis back up to a 19-point lead.
Ooh, 4:35 left. Bennington's got a long ways to go.
Well, that was a terrible call because Bennington knocked it out of bounds.
I mean, my golly. Me.
Oh, yeah, we're supposed to be enjoying the game. And we are. Kenton Lonberger in for Ryan Wheadle, and Ryan will get a breather.
In case you folks haven't caught on, we got a pair of brothers, a pair of Brown brothers and Lonberger brothers on this team. That can be confusing to some of you, maybe. It's confusing to us at times. Rathman, short. He didn't follow his own shot like his dad would have told him to. Corman with the ball. Wheel brings it up. Brown, short, didn't follow his shot. 3:54 left.
Kenton working hard on defense.
They want to get her in the big fella. And yes, Trevor Atkins heads up, gets it up to Lonberger. Yes!
Actually,
folks, I think we just blown this baby wide open.
No call, but of course they haven't called it all. Oh, gosh. Blocking foul on Spencer Brown. And
then he calls a little nitpick like that. Lions, number 23, Spencer Brown, his first personal foul, 6th team foul. 69-48. Knight, 21-point lead with 3:25 left. Bennington has the ball. They're juking and joking there and trying to get it inside.
Come on, Spencer, get in the game. There you go. Trevor picks up the
ball. Yeah, baby. Yeah.
Well, I got Spencer's credit. They had him by the arm down there, and that's why he couldn't move.
Yeah. Folks, 71-48.
What a great fourth quarter by the Lions. We must have put on a 20 to 9 spurt there. All said and done, Dale's doing some ciphering, but I tell you. How much? 17-2 run by Minneapolis. We needed it. We're down to a 6-point lead.
Yeah, I mean, that 6 points had me concerned. But to think we got a 21-point lead now, or 23. Okay, folks, we're back in action. Bennington brings up the ball. Nice play by Minneapolis. They're fighting for the ball. I don't know about that one.
Called out on Spencer, and
Bennington retains possession. Two minutes and 51 seconds left. This game will be history. Bennington brings it up. They know they're defeated.
Good hustle by Spencer. Almost had that steal earlier. Turnaround jumper by Bennington.
Up to Brown. Lonberger from downtown. Yes!
Three-pointer. 14 points by Kenton here in the second half.
Foul on Will Corman, I believe.
74-50. First foul, 2:15 left, and Ryan and Kenton go out. Great second half by Kent Lonberger, 14 point.
You betcha.
Performance. We needed it because we just need that for offense. Ryan didn't hardly get a shot. I think he got a layup. That's about all.
Off, no good. Owens with the rebound. He pushes up to Brown. Brown stops. Will Corman out front. He's a good ball handler. Into Owens, or Gaspin. No good.
Traer with a nice turnaround jumper, just a little short.
We're under 2 minutes, folks. To 50, Lions with a 24-point lead. Gaspin with the foul, I believe.
Reach-in foul on Traer Gaspin. We're over the limit. Bennington will shoot a 1-1.
The girls play Saturday night for the championship. Is that correct?
Yeah, I hope they score 63 points again. They'll have their work cut out for them playing Sacred Heart.
I get to go down and see a little niece in a play tomorrow at Lawrence, so I won't be able to be here.
Oh, big rebound by Jamal. One hand up there drags out that rebound. I like that.
1:34 left. Townsend with the ball. Over to Corman. Over to Brown. Owens. He's thinking. Back out to Brown. Oh, bad pass there by Brown. Rathburn's going to take it in. Let him go. Oh, he missed her.
Nice defense by
Townsend. Hang on, buddy.
Spencer.
Gassman.
And he gets the rebound.
Yep.
Coach Williams comes up with a loose ball, and he's going to jack it from 30.
Folks, we have 67 seconds left in this ball game. The Lions will win third place and go 2-1 for the season. We met the Bennington challenge. They cut it down to 6, but we mounted a
nice 17-2 run.
74-52, there's 56 seconds left.
Corey Lomberger in.
Corman with the ball. Owens, yes!
Yeah, nice shot.
Cross court.
Jamal. Looked like a good block. Must have caught him with the body, and Bennington will get 2 shots.
Personal foul on the Lions, number 15, Jamal Townsend, his third.
That's his third foul.
29 seconds left. First shot's good.
So, Trace, how do you think Bennington will fare up at the 3A sub-state up at Beloit with Riley County and Beloit and Phillipsburg? And
my advice is practice, practice, practice. Watch a lot of film.
Are you going to make a prediction, Dale?
I don't think they'll get by the opening round.
Yeah.
That's going to be a tough sub-state.
What's a look? Corman, back to Owens. We're down to 13 seconds. This game's about over, folks. Lions will win. Oh, Corman. Oh, all right. Townsend with a nice rebound. 3 seconds.
Jack it, Corey, jack it.
That's it, folks. Ball game's over, 76-54. Lions win third place in the tournament here.
Big Blue takes one from Bennington, 3 in a row now on a 3-win winning streak. 76-54. 22-8 in the fourth quarter. We outscored them, so.
We need
big quarter for Minneapolis.
I'll tell you what. We got her down to 6 there. That was of concern.
It was scary.
Scary.
You know, the rest of these guys have to step up, and Canton did second half with a 14-point.
Oh, yeah.
They had a couple threes and nice little 8-footers in the lane, and that's what it's going to take. Other guys are going to have to step up and score.
Yeah, I mean, it can't be the Ryan Wheeler show. That's not going to work.
Ryan only had 1 shot in the second half, so he had 27. With 1 layup, that's it. Checks right there. We're getting our medals. Third place. Nice win. Pressed just a little bit there at the beginning of the second half. Kind of deja vu. We had a 13-0 run against us against Halstead. Dale, it kind of brought them back in the game, and Bennington came back with a big run in the third quarter and got them back in the game. Got it down within six, and then Minneapolis with a 22-8 run in the fourth quarter put it away for Minneapolis. They'll get a few of those tight games, and they'll get those gimmick defenses, a box and one, man-to-man against Ryan Weedle all over the floor, and zone of the rest of the guys. I thought Bennington did a real nice job with it, and we finally decided that someone else is going to have to score, and we did. Kenton and Nick Spencer, and then Cameron started warming up in the fourth quarter, ended up with 6 or 8 points there in the fourth quarter. So nice job. Team effort tonight. It was a one-man show in the first half, but it was team effort all the way, and the rest of the team had to show, and they did. Flying colors in the second half. Nice job. Dale's working on stats. We're getting ready for the championship game here with Sacred Heart and Halstead. And he said it will start in about 30 minutes. Minneapolis with pretty balanced scoring in the second half. Kenton Lonberger, I think, ended up with about 18 points, scored 4, I believe, in the first half and 14 in the second half. So he stepped up big, and they needed him to because the way they had Ryan covered up. Let me give this mic over to Dale, and we'll let Dale wrap it up for us.
Is he on? You got me? All right. Scoring for the Lions tonight, 4 points for Peyton Owens, 4 points for Nick Brown. He hit, more than that. Six points for Nick Brown. 6 points for Trevor Adkins. 6 points for Spencer Brown. 2 points for Jamel Townsend. 7 points for Cameron Knox. 18 points for Kenton Lonberger. And the leading scorer on the night, I think, for both teams, Ryan Weedle, 27 points on 12 of 14 shooting.
12 of 14 shooting is...
He took one shot in the second half.
Is excellent shooting, and I believe he was 3 of 4 from four-point land. At 12 of 14.
Yes, 3 of 4 from beyond the arc.
12 of 14 was the two-pointers, and...
Kenton was 2 for 3 beyond the arc. Spencer Brown was 1 for 1 beyond the arc, and Nick Brown was 2 for 3 from beyond the arc.
You know, we had a better shooting percentage from beyond three-point land than we did at the free throw line, is fine with me.
Yeah. We only hit 4 points on,
I just remembered we missed quite a few. I thought maybe we were down 30-40%. I think we hit.
We were 50% on from the free throw line. So, yeah.
Three-pointers were.
You're right.
Pretty good shape.
Trevor Adkins and Nick Brown.
So the Lions moved to 1-1, third or 2-1, third place finish here. And next Tuesday we go to Beloit for the NCAA League.
Ryan Weedle.
And the girls will be here tomorrow night for the league the tournament championships game. See if we can take one of those traveling trophies home.
And they're playing real well, two games in a row, and scoring over 50 points a ball game and 63 in their second game.
Sacred Heart only beat them by 10 up in Minneapolis last year.
They did a great job getting the ball inside, and I don't think Shannon Bouchard's going to be playing. I think she had some late season surgery on a shoulder or knee or something after volleyball. And
that'll hurt them.
Yeah, she's an excellent ball player. Yeah. I think I might be wrong, but last I heard on the radio, she was setting out their first game, and she's back. I'd be surprised.
The Lady Lions have opened up 2-0, and it's the first time that's happened since 1995.
2-0 and scored over 100 points in those two ball games, and I don't think you and I have ever sat here and talked about that before, but Coach Darrow's got them playing pretty good defense. They're getting a lot of points inside with Jordan Cross and scored 19 one game and 15 the other game. Mm-hmm. So those are big buckets in close, and we're hitting from the outside, which, you know, that second game when we scored 63, the girls were hitting their 12, 14 footers, and that's a good deal.
So folks, if you come to see basketball at Minneapolis High School this year, come for both games, because you're cheating yourself if you miss one, because you're going to see excellent basketball this year out of both sets, of both groups.
Definitely. Lady Lions are going to be right up there at the top coming to the end of the season, doing a real good job. Yeah. Very deep on the bench. I made a note to Coach Darrow this morning down at the gas station. I said, gosh, Coach, Dale and I are just at awe at how you can go 10 deep on your bench, bring five in and take five out, and just keep on trucking. He says, yeah, it's luxury. It's nice to have 10 that can play, and he's tier three deep at every position. Yeah. So he's got a pretty good ball club, and they're playing hard for him right now.
So Chuck Lomberger, Trace Grebe, Mike Perry, and Dale Leach signing off for the MHS linebackers here from the Bicentennial Center for Channel 37 and the linebackers. Good night, folks.